Hi, this is Kristen from the Pros and Cons team, and today I'm really excited to talk to you about the pros and cons of staying up on current events. So to start off, growing up, I really did not like current events, and then something changed, and I began to like it. So let's talk about it. So some of the pros of listening and keeping up on current events is that you are informed, and when you're informed, you can make a difference in the world. It's hard to make a difference in the world on that type of a scale if you're not informed of a problem or issue and know a lot on that problem or issue. That was something I realized. I began to be more interested in current events when I was serving a mission for my church, for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and I was serving in Portugal. And I met this lady who was from the Congo. And during the time I was serving my mission, there was the Ebola outbreak, and she had had several family members die. And she was saying how she would want to send money, but she knew that any money she sent would not end up helping the people that needed the help. And I felt like there were so many nonprofits and so many governments that were probably just sending money, and really it wasn't getting to where it needed to be because of some of the corruption in the government over there, which was really sad to realize. But if those people had known better of the dynamic of the Congo, they could have better helped them out in different ways, and maybe ways that could have actually helped those people that needed help. So that's something that I really like. It's really also fun. You can do political debates with people if you're up on current events. I love political debates, as long as they're not rude. I don't like when people are rude about it. I'm totally good with different opinions, but when people are rude, it's not nice. But I love to do that, and so that is something that is really great. Another thing is, if you are wanting to fight against a bill, you need to be up on current events. I was an intern for the state capitol, and it was really interesting because I realized how many bills slip under the table and nobody fights against them because people are not informed. Yes, there will be lobbyists, like on major bills, there will be a bunch of lobbyists, but a lot of them like go under the table. In my state this year, there was like a really weird bill that passed about how much, like the suggested amount that people should have during Christmas if they're divorced, their kids should split, and it wasn't an even split, and it caused a lot of problems and a lot of confusion, but it just slipped through because people weren't informed and they weren't keeping up to fight against it and be like, wait a second, this is not a good idea. So there are things like that, that it's easier to fight it as a bill versus a law. So that was something that it is really helpful if you stay up on current events. Some of the negatives is it can be super depressing. Have I cried while I have been reading the news? Yes. There are so many horrible things that are going on in the world, and it can be really depressing. Also, it can give you a skewed perspective of what is actually happening in the world. Sometimes when we read the news, we just think everybody is out there to rob, to steal, to murder, to like just destroy the world. And like that sounds maybe a little bit dramatic, but it feels like that. There's very few times that I read a news article that's like, yes, that just made me feel so good. It doesn't happen very often, because the ones that are more intense and depressing usually probably sell more and they get more money off of. And that's just kind of like the nature of the news. And so it can give you a skewed perspective of the world. There is a lot of good in the world. And so you have to keep that in mind, that you are reading probably the worst of everything. So that's another thing that is bad about the news. It can also take a ton of time to stay up, and you'll never be caught up on current events. There's just too many current events. But it can take a lot of time, and it can almost become an obsession and a rabbit hole where you just keep going and going and going, because there will always be news that you can find. So that is another con, is like you have to have that balance of like how much is worth it and how much is like we should wait. So I hope you enjoyed my list of pros and cons. Check out more pros and cons click the link below. And if you want to add any, please comment below. And I hope to see you next time. See ya. Bye.